Coming up, we are going to have a look how you can get central visibility, organization, and management for all your customers and all your locations using Azure Arc and Azure Lighthouse. I'm here with Lior, Cloud Solution Architect at Microsoft and the author behind the Azure Arc Jumpstart project.
Hey, Thomas. Nice to be here again.
So, Lior, you worked with customers and you also worked with managed service providers. So what are the challenging parts when you look at the task of a managed service provider today?
Yeah, so, you know, when it comes to service providers, they need to have visibility to their customers, their tenants, right? And using Azure Lighthouse, they can do that today. The challenge that they have is that they don't have visibility to the resources that are deployed outside of Azure. And that's really the challenge, because they want to have an holistic view to their customers, to their tenants. And today we're going to talk about that.
Yeah, no, this is awesome. Again, Azure Lighthouse really helps these managed service providers to actually manage like multiple tenants and the Azure resources within these tenants. Now, as you mentioned, customers do not only have resources running in Azure, right? They often are running in a hybrid or multi-cloud environment. They have servers and Kubernetes clusters and databases running outside of Azure in their on-premise environment, or even, as I mentioned, other cloud providers. So how can now Azure Arc and Azure Lighthouse help us with that?
You know, if you're thinking about Azure Arc, right, and we talked about that Azure Arc provides you that capability to project resources that are deployed outside of Azure, into our control plane. And the fact that customers are able to do that, that also means that the Azure Lighthouse users, which are the which is the service providers, right, they now have this visibility to the Arc resources as well. So if we're thinking about it, now the service provider not only has like access to the native Azure resources, now he's got that visibility to the resources that are deployed outside of Azure. The result of that kind of visibility is the fact that the service provider can offer to his customers the policy, the governance, the security, the management capabilities that are applied on Azure resources, but now also for Arc resources. And that gives a lot of power when it comes to how you're actually managing at scale multiple customers in multiple environments and platforms that they are deploying their resources on.
Wow, okay. So the combination of Azure Lighthouse and Azure Arc is actually really powerful, because as customers can onboard their resources outside of Azure and get that single control plane over their whole environment, with Azure Lighthouse, service providers can get that single control plane for multiple customers, which is awesome. Now, we were talking now a lot about service providers, right? Can also enterprise customers or other organizations, which some of them also need to manage multiple tenants, leverage that, or is it for service providers only?
Yeah, definitely. Azure Lighthouse can give you the flexibility here. And this is not just for service provider. An enterprise organization can use Azure Lighthouse internally to manage multiple tenants that they have internally in their organization. Think about the situation where a company is acquiring other companies and now they want to manage those tenants and leave those as independent Azure tenants. Azure Lighthouse can definitely give you that flexibility. And again, because those tenants also have resources that are Arc resources, the Lighthouse admin or the organization can now have that visibility to those Arc resources. A lot of flexibility there.
Okay, this is awesome, especially if I think about like compliance or security administrators, which need to have that view over all environments. But then also, for example, about IT administrators, which are in charge of like making sure that everything is up to date and monitoring and all that good stuff. Now, you mentioned this and you showed me some graphics how that looks like, but I actually want to see a little bit like how it actually works and see it in action.
Right. So today what we're going to show is the visibility from the Lighthouse administrator, but also how does that look like from the tenant perspective. So let's look at what we have here. On the left side, the dark team, we have the Lighthouse admin. On the right side, we have the tenant. That's actually the customer. Now, the process around Azure Lighthouse is very simple, right? You're basically, you as the tenant, you're giving access to the service provider. And from that point, the service provider has access to manage and govern your resources. So let's see how does that look like. Like I said, on the right side, I have the tenant, and on the left side, I have the service provider. So from the right side, you can see that here I have a service provider offer, right? The service provider is basically offering me a service, right? That's the plan. That's what encapsulates that management aspect coming from Lighthouse. And on the left side, if I'll go to manage my customers and look at the customers, you can see that here I have the customer. That's the customer that the Lighthouse admin is actually managing on behalf. So that's what we have here. Now, how does that get translated to the Azure world and the management? Let's see that. You can see here that the tenant already has a resource group. That's the managed resources resource group. And he's got virtual machines, but he also has got a bunch of Azure Arc enabled servers and an Azure Arc enabled SQL resource, right? So the tenant is leveraging Azure Arc. He's managing resources that are deployed outside of Azure and also SQL server that is deployed outside of Azure. And that's all good. But because the service provider using Lighthouse now has this access to the customer environment, what the tenant will see is the following. You can see here that without Azure Arc, that the service provider will only see those virtual machines. Those are Azure native virtual machines. But if we'll expand that scope that we have here for the resource group, you can see that actually the service provider is seeing exactly what the tenant is seeing. And that's exactly where Lighthouse comes in, right? It gives you that ability to make that relationship between the customer and the service provider. And at that point, the service provider can actually see what the customer is seeing and managing those resources.
Okay, that is really impressive. So when you're talking about managing, actually, like, what can I do? Is there some limitation on how I can manage these resources? Or do I get the same management experience as I would as the customer itself?
Because Azure Arc is basically all about projecting resources and make them first-class citizens inside the control plane, that gives you the ability to manage those resources the same way as you will manage native Azure resources. And for the service provider, that's no different. So if we'll go back to the service provider view, you can see here that these are the servers, the Arc-enabled servers that the customer actually onboarded. But if we will dive into one of these servers, you can see that the service provider basically have the same experience. If I will click here on the right side for the tenant, you can see, again, this is the same experience, same view between the service provider and the tenant. So the tenant, what he can do, he can basically manage all those resources and using things like monitoring, update management, Azure policy, logs, etc., because of the fact that those resources are now part of his management domain. So that's really powerful.
I don't think this is just limited to the portal, right? You can also use APIs and other management tools to actually automate these processes. And if I'm now a managed service provider, I actually have the capabilities to create offerings on that, like based on, like, for example, I can say I can create a update offering to manage like my customers' servers and provide them every month with like all the updates installed and build that automation around it. Or I can make some compliance views and say, well, we check your servers for compliance. So I can build many, many value added services for my customers. So that is pretty cool.
Right. And, you know, Azure Lighthouse is really about managing offerings, right? It's really about bundling those offerings between the service provider and what he can actually provide to his customers, his tenants, right? And again, we said that it doesn't really matter if it's a service provider and a customer or an enterprise organization that is managing multi-tenant environment. So definitely, you're right. You can bundle those offerings and provide those to your tenants.
So I'm sure there are now many customers out there which are interested in learning more about Azure Lighthouse and in combination with, for example, Azure Arc. So can you explain a little bit where should they go and where can they find more information around us?
So we created a lot of technical resources. And the first resource that you want to visit is the Azure Arc Jumpstart. The Azure Arc Jumpstart provide you with a zero to hero experience and automated scenarios for you to get going with Azure Arc. And we also created a dedicated scenario for Azure Lighthouse and Azure Arc, so you can go and check that out. The second resource is Microsoft Learn. We created a lot of learning models for Azure Arc. Those will get you going with the fundamentals all the way to advanced level comes to Azure Arc, these are great resources for you to visit. The third resource is the tech community. The tech community is where our bloggers are coming and announcing new features, new capabilities with Azure Arc, give their perspective on how to use the technology. And again, another awesome resource for you to visit.
Awesome. Thank you very much, Lior. And for those who are watching, if you want to learn more about hybrid and multi-cloud architectures, check out our Cloud Adoption Framework and our Azure Architecture Center.